Can't believe I got taken by her. That cheap black dress. I want to give something back.
Don't blame yourself. I was too. So, what's the plan?
I'm trying to reach the trigger of my crossbow.
And if you do?
I was hoping to shoot a bolt up through the sand, hit that palm tree there, maybe pull myself out.
Excellent idea.
It might be, except that I can't reach the trigger of my crossbow. The sand is like cement.
Okay, what's plan B?
There is no plan B.
You always have a plan B. So I take it I would be justified in panicking. Well, in that case, I think there are a few things I should say under the circumstances.
Like?
I want to thank you for all the opportunities you've shown me. It's been an incredible life. Looks like it's going to be a little short, but incredible.
I'm just glad to have you here with me, Nige.
And also, I want to thank you for your friendship and your trust. They mean the world to me. Not that I want to get sentimental at a time like this when we're buried up next in sand, but...
I feel the same way, Nigel.
I never even got to know Karen. She seems like such a friendly girl, and I don't want to die. But what I'm trying to say is, considering it doesn't look like we're going to get out of this particular situation, I love you, Sid. I don't mean in a dirty, lustful, salacious way. I mean, well, not that you're not an attractive woman, but...
Okay, Mitch. I love you, too.
Shall we spend our last few moments on Earth screaming for help?
Sure.
Well, that was a better result than I expected.
So I was talking to Becky, my best friend, and I told her what you said.
Could you dig us out? We can chat about your friend later.
She said, that sounds familiar, about us purchasing our happiness at the cost of your fiancé's life. And I said, Bex, what do you mean familiar? And she said...
We could be inhaling water soon.
And she said she heard that exact same dialogue in some cornball movie her mother was watching on The Late Show a month ago. And I said it couldn't be. But then she told me some more, and it was almost exactly the same as what you said.
All right, all right, all right. You've got me fair and square. I apologize, unreservedly. Now, could you please start digging us out?
You said you were speaking to me from your heart.
I'm speaking to you from my heart now, and I say, help!
Sam, I know you must be terribly hurt. And Nigel deserves to be punished.
I do? I do, yes.
But he doesn't deserve to drown. And I'd rather not.
I suppose you're right. I'll dig you out first.